Alone among the writers of his generation, Christopher Isherwood can be said to have achieved true greatness. Shut up, idiot. The only book I've ever written has received 5 reviews, all bad, and has sold 232 copies to date. And I haven't even started this one, though I've been here already 6 months. Well, we're gonna start now. We're not gonna get out of this chair until we do. All right, let's start. So, chapter 1. Okay, write something, anything, create something. I am a camera with its shutter open, quite passive. Someday, all of this will have to be developed. Carefully printed, fixed. Who is it?
It is I, Harry Tubal.
Oh, go in, Fräulein Schneider.
I bring you this tea cloth. When you are having a lady guest, you can trust Schneider Shen to make things elegant. Now, where do you want all these things to go, Harry Tubal?
You can put them on the floor.
You cannot put things on the floor.
Why not? There's plenty of things there already.
Well, they must not stay there. Not if you are having a lady guest. It does not look good at all.
Oh, well, then you can put them in the bedroom. Not be any there.
And how do you know that, Harry Sigma, a handsome man like you?
For that Schneider, I'm surprised by you.
Oh, I have been young too. Young and saucy.
I assume you had a great many admirers.
Oh, I had dozens. But only one friend. 11 years we were together. Then he died. It was after that I became fat. The bosom, you know, it grew and it grew. And it is such a weight to carry about with you. It's like carrying around a suitcase. 2 suitcases. And it is sad it should have grown after he died. He was a man for bosoms. It would have made him so happy. And now it does no one any good. This young lady we're expecting. Is she very attractive?
She is one of my pupils. Though, when I say she's one of my pupils, that's not very true, now is it? She's my only pupil. The rest have gone for the summer, and she wanted to see where I lived. Fräulein Schneider, I must tell you something.
Yeah, Harry Siebel?
I can't go on living here anymore.
What? Oh, Harry Siebel, you are not going to leave me. Are you not comfortable here?
Why, yes, I'm very comfortable. It's just that, well, I can't afford it anymore.
Well, that can wait.
No, I can't. I haven't paid you for 2 months. Not properly, at least. Listen, I've got to credit you. Say, that room, that small room just across the hall, it isn't let.
But it is so small, Harry Siebel. Why, you could hardly get into it. And what do I do with this room? With the summer coming on, I shall never find a tenant for it.
Sure you will.
Okay.
And in the meantime, why don't you live in here instead of living in the sitting room?
I like the sitting room. I can look on the corner and see what's going on. And believe me, Harry Siebel, there is plenty. Those women, they're as old as I am almost, and they stand there and whisper to the men who come by, "Come, Susar." And believe me, Harry Siebel, they come. Sometimes I think I shall adopt that profession myself.
Fräulein Schneider, the room across the hall, how much do you charge for it?
I charge 28 marks when times were good.
28? I can't afford that.
Ah, Duama Yuma, of course you can rent it. I will not have you leave. You rent it for 20 marks.
Oh, Fräulein Schneider, you're very sweet.
Sweet? Yeah, once I was sweet. Sweet as a sugar cake. Now I am sweet like a fat old bun. And soon, you make a great deal of money with your stories that you are always writing, and you take this room again, and everyone is happy once more.
And then I'll buy you a fur coat.
Yeah, I'll become one of the ladies. Only I will not go up and down the street in those high heels. I will sit at my window in my fur coat, and I'll call out, "Come, Susur, come to the third floor." And then I'll open up my coat a little, just a little. And what do you think I have on underneath? Nothing! I have nothing on underneath! Oh my God! There's the bell. That will be your young lady.
You need not tell her that I'm leaving this room.
Of course, you can trust me perfectly. And I've got paper serviettes for your coffee. Most ladies appreciate these things.
She says you expect the lady?
Oh, why, yes, but that doesn't matter. Come on in.
Yes.
Would you like some coffee?
Black coffee.
Oh, Schneider, coffee for three, please.
You are too good, Harris. You entertain whoever comes, no matter whoever.
I do not think your landlady likes me. But that is with me, all right. Ultimately, I do not like her either. In fact, Chris, I think the world is lousy.
Oh, is this bad?
Oh, it is terrible, lousy and terrible. Or else I get a deal in a month, or else I go as a gigolo.
Well, either or, it's just a force of habit.
Oh, no, I'm speaking lousy English now. But Sally says maybe she's giving me a few lessons.
Who is this Sally?
She's a friend of mine. Ultimately, she is coming over this afternoon, and I would like to get to know, or I'd like the two of you to get to know each other.
Oh, is she a girlfriend of yours?
No, not the actress, but she is wonderful.
Well, who is this Sally? What does she do?
She is an actress. She's performing at the Lady Windermere. Hot stuff, believe me. She's a bit French, ultimately. I think her mother was French, or something.
I wonder what Natalia will think of her. Natalia Landauer is the pupil that I'm expecting.
Landauer of the department store.
Why, yes, it's her father owns it. It's a family business.
So they must be enormously wealthy.
Oh, yes, stinking rich.
Hmm. And you are going to marry her?
No, of course I'm not going to marry her.
You do not want her.
Well, not only as a pupil.
So if, say, the two of us should meet and I should make a pass, you would not mind?
She has not yet seen her.
That does not matter, Chris. I mean, mommy, her father is wealthy. Maybe he will take a liking to me. A job in the business. If I marry her, a partnership perhaps.
What makes you think she will take you?
All women will have me if I want them.
Well, not Sally, apparently.
Sally has been too busy with other men, but soon she will be free and I will get my look in.
Or maybe you'll be all tied up with Natalia.
Yes, ultimately business must come first. I suppose she is Jewish?
Oh, yes.
Well, there is always something. You know, Chris, I'm very broad-minded.
That must be her.
Chris, how do I look? How is my hair? Is it gray hair?
It looks gray.
Oh, yes, willing. No, this is too much, Chris. You see, Chris, dear, you must help me arrange the marriage settlement.
There, is she with
us at the Sioux
House?
Chris, your coat.
No, what?
She's a lady, very elegant.
He is not here. He is not Sioux House. But he's expected. Isn't there a Vandal here?
Sally?
Chris, yes. Darling. Oh, the old lady said there was no
room. Come in. Sally, this is Chris. Chris, this is Sally. Sally Bowles.
How do you do?
I'm terribly glad to meet you.
Fräulein Schneider, a coffee for four.
Oh, not for me. I'm allergic to coffee. It puts me in the most sinister spots if I drink it before dinner.
Oh, just for three, then.
I always have prairie oysters for breakfast. Have you ever heard of them? Eggs with Worcestershire sauce, all whooshed up together. Oh, I simply live on them. Actually, I don't suppose I could have a whiskey and soda, could I? I'm simply dead.
I haven't got any whiskey.
I thought you were English.
Well, yes, but, I'm also very poor.
Oh, so am I. I'm terribly poor, but I always have whiskey. I mean, I think one must. Am I terribly late, Fritz, darling?
Oh, you're beautifully on time.
Oh, I thought I wasn't going to be able to come at all. I had the most frantic row with my landlady. Finally, I just sent Pig and swept out.
We might have a sponsored gin.
Oh, gin would be wonderful.
What would you like in this or this in?
Well, do you have anything besides coffee?
No, not
that. Well, then I'll just have it straight.
Oh, but it will have to be the tooth glass.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Okay.
Give me one of your marvelous cigarettes, Fritz, darling. Oh, have you ever smoked one of Fritz's cigarettes? They're absolutely devastating. They must be full of opium or something. Oh, they always make me feel marvelously sensual.
Here,
go ahead. Oh, thank you. Oh, this has got an extraordinary taste to it. It's like peppermint.
Oh, I must not wash it out properly. That must be the remains of the mouthwash.
Oh, well, I think it's lovely. Here, Fritz, taste it.
Mm-hmm.
It is extremely interesting.
Oh, here, Chris, try it. Perhaps we can all make a fortune selling mint-flavored gin.
What for was the role with your landlady?
Oh, well, you should have heard the things that she said about me. I mean, well, I suppose in a way I am a bit of a tart. I mean, in a nice way. Oh, but one doesn't like to hear those things. And all because I brought a man home with me last night. Oh, but I'm terribly in love with him.
anyone I know?
You'll never guess. Klaus.
Klaus? Klaus! Your company, Miss Klaus.
Yes, oh, my company, Miss Klaus. Oh, he was always just like a part of the piano to me. Oh, but then last night, oh, he was absolutely astonishing. He made me feel like a faun, the most marvelous little nymph in the middle of a forest, nobody around at all. And then the landlady came in and she made the most boring remarks, and well, I simply couldn't stay. I guess I'll have to find a new room. I don't suppose you know of any, do you?
A room?
Well, something a little like this, perhaps.
Well, there is this one.
Are you leaving?
Oh, I'm just moving across the hall. I can't afford to live here anymore.
Oh, well, is it terribly expensive?
Well, I pay 50 marks a month, and that includes breakfast.
Oh, well, 50? I pay 80 for mine. That's nothing. And this is very nice. Is this your bedroom back here? I think it's sweet all tucked away like that. Oh, that's where you keep things.
Only for occasional visitors.
You mean I could really have this? How soon?
As soon as you'd like. I only have to move across the hall. It'll only take a minute, and I'm sure Fräulein Schneider will be very anxious to let it.
Oh, but what is she like? I mean, is she going to give me trouble if I bring men home occasionally? It would only be very occasionally, because I do think one ought to go to the man's rooms if one can. This doesn't look so much as though one were sort of expecting it. And men feel very keenly about these type of things. Oh, but it wouldn't be men anyhow. It would only be Klaus. I decided to be absolutely loyal to him. Oh, she wouldn't mind that, would she, or would she?
Well, I don't think she would mind just about anything, if she would be willing to let it to you.
I say, am I shocking you talking like this?
No, nobody ever shocks me when they try to.
Oh, why do you say that I'm trying to shock you?
Well, I have an idea that you like to try and shock everybody. I mean, why else do you paint your nails green?
Oh, well, I think it's pretty, don't you?
Oh, yes, but suppose you thought it would be pretty to paint dirty pictures on them. Now, would you do that too?
Dirty pictures? Well, I'm not so sure about dirty ones, but maybe stimulating ones. Oh, I should find someone to do it for me. Is he really unshockable, Fritz, or is he just pretending?
Well, Chris, no, he is quite unshockable. I've tried many times, but ultimately, I cannot do it.
Although there is one person who is quite shockable who will be joining us shortly, and so please do mind being just a little bit more careful with what you say. She's one of my pupils and I do rather need her.
Oh, of course, darling. I will be terribly ladylike.
And you need not tell her that I'm leaving this room. I don't either need her to know how broke I am.
I won't be the word.
Oh, that must be her.
Oh, you better put the gin away.
Yes.
I'm afraid there isn't time for me to clean my nails. I guess I'll keep my fist clenched. Here, is your what? Yeah, maybe
for Erwan. Here is the Thomas. Natalia, come, meet my friends. Miss Bowles, Fräulein Landauer, and Herr Wendel, Fräulein Landauer.
Sir's friends are Canadian
style. Though she'd rather speak in English. She speaks marvelous English.
I'm most charmed, dearest.
How do you do?
I am well. I just got over a cold, but I'm better now.
I'm sorry. Colds are beastly things. One's head gets all stuffed up.
Yes, but this was a cold in the chest, not the head. Oh, the phlegm was here.
The what?
The phlegm in the tubes.
It's pronounced phlegm. You pronounce the H.
Oh, well, then why do you say pithesis? Would your Lady Camilla have and not pronounce the H there, too?
Well,
there must be a reason. You give it to me, please?
Well, you don't say pittesis either, now do you?
Well, you should just say lead and leave it at that. I eat lead in my chest, is it not so? It is not an exact language or English.
What is pittesis?
Oh, it is consumption from the lungs. The lungs are consumed in phlegm.
Oh, well, would you mind not going on about it? I think I'm going to be sick.
Well, why should you be sick? You do not have it.
Well, I'll talk about illness makes me sick. I saw a most awful film about syphilis the other day. Oh, it was terrible. I couldn't let a man touch me for almost a week. Is it true you can get it from kissing?
Oh, yes, and your king, Henry VIII, he got it from letting the Cardinal Hucelou whisper to him.
That is not, I think, founded in fact. Kissing most decidedly, yes, and cups and towels and... Oh, I hope these all have been cleaned properly.
Oh, yes, Fräulein Schneider always boils just about everything.
Well, you can't expect a man to go out and have tests and things done before you let him touch you. I mean, there isn't time. He'd be off in a nip for someone far less particular.
Natalia, would you like some coffee?
Yes, please.
Oh, can I have a talk with your landlady, Chris, dear?
Well, we've got plenty of time.
Oh, we'll talk outside. We'll have secrets together. Oh, excuse me.
Most obligingly, when they get so nice.
Would allow me to pass you the hair tart. They are cakes, dear Smith.
I thank you, but no, I do not eat between meals, and this is not a proper way to address a lady in English. No sugar, neither, just plain black coffee.
That too is how I like it.
Oh, will you tell me, please, about Fräulein Gold? She is a remarkable girl.
She is a nice of theirs, a very talented.
Where does she perform?
She is performing at a club called the Lady Windermere. You know perhaps the play, of course, by Oscar Wilde, calling the Lady Windermere's Fair?
Called Lady Windermere's Fair by Oscar Wilde? But of course I know it. I have read it both in German and in English. I prefer German, but the club I do not know.
You would allow me to take you there one night to hear Sally sing?
Are you sure that's the right place to take Fräulein Mandela?
But why not?
Oh, I don't know. I just think...
You think what?
I don't know, really. It's just...
You don't know? Then I cannot help you.
Well, I just thought it might be a little bit too... bohemian.
Oh. Well, I think I'm going to go. When are you available?
You could go tonight, if you're free.
Yes, I can be free. I will give you my address. Oh, and Christopher, you can come too, and it'll be a party to hear your girlfriend sing.
She's not my girlfriend.
No? Then what is she?
Well, just a friend.
Oh, and is she not a girl?
Well, yes, but,
Then why is she not a girlfriend?
Well, girlfriend is meaning something who is a, more than a friend, who is a girlfriend.
Then what does it mean?
It's meaning sweetheart.
Oh, so I did not know. So I am not a sweetheart of yours, Christopher, or a girlfriend?
Unfortunately not.
You do not mean that, Christopher. You only say that to be polite.
No, but he ought to.
Think
I think very much.
Then you too are polite.
No, I'm not polite. I'm only sincere.
It's all fixed up, Chris, dear. Oh, your landlady was almost in tears of gratitude.
Oh, why was she so grateful?
Because I'm moving in here.
Sally, we were coming to hear you sing tonight.
Oh, tonight? Oh, but my dear, I shall be exhausted. I didn't sleep a wink last night.
Would you rather us come a different evening?
Oh, well, I expect it will be fine, only don't let the proprietor bother you. He's a darling, really, but he smokes dope quite a lot, and sometimes it doesn't agree with him, and then he pinches people. Oh, but he doesn't mean anything by it.
I think I'm pulling my safe away now.
You would allow me to accompany you?
My dear young man, I am not but 60 years old, and I can go home by myself unmolested.
Weder Fräulein, weder schön, kein unbeleitet nach Hause gehen.
Oh, what's that?
From Faust?
It means I'm not a virgin, and I'm not beautiful, and I can go home alone.
Ah, well, this is not true. None of this is true. Not in this case, of course.
You mean Fräulein Landauer is a virgin? How do you know?
Oh, you are filled with interesting curiosity. But I really must be going. Goodbye, Christopher. I think I'll be talking to your landlady on the way out. I do not like this place, and I think she's charging me too much. Goodbye.
I do not think that girl liked me very much.
No, I don't think she did.
Well, I can't imagine why. I was trying my best. It won't make any difference to you, will it, to your lessons?
No, I don't think so. Natalia is quite broad-minded in an intellectual sort of way. I figured she'll think it's her duty to understand you.
What on earth got into Fritz? I can't imagine what got into him. I mean, he isn't after her, is he?
Well, she is very rich and he is very poor.
Think he would get anywhere with her?
Well, Fritz always likes to make himself out to be attractive to all women.
Oh, well, I can't imagine she would find him attractive after his going on like that. No, I think the best way with a girl of that kind would be to make a pounce.
Oh, well, I don't imagine anybody making a pounce on Natalia.
Exactly. That's why it would be so effective.
No, that's quite wonderful, you sell
it. Well, it's quite simple to me. Here, give me the rest of that gin, will you, Chris? There's only a little bit left, and then that way you won't have to take the bottle.
Yes, of course.
Oh, and you're going to be right down the hall. I took a look at the room. Well, it's not very nice, but you can use this one anytime you like, and then if you're low or I am, well, we can just sob on each other's bosoms. Well, I must say, Fräulein Schneider's got a very big one, hasn't she? Oh, almost like an opera singer, or those women in the music halls that could make theirs dance. Do you think that we could get her to do that?
You might train her.
Chapter one. Are you writing a novel?
Starting one.
I'm a camera with the shutter open, quite passive. Do you mean this is a story written by a camera?
No. It's written by me. I'm the camera.
Well, how do you mean?
Well, I'm the one who sees it all. I don't really take part. I don't even really think. I just, sort of photograph it and ask questions, maybe. Sally, how long have you been in Germany?
Oh, about 2 months.
And where in England is your family from?
Lancashire. My father owns a mill, several mills.
Oh, but your mother is French. Fritz, he told me.
Oh, well, Fritz is an idiot. He's always inventing things. No, Mummy's a bit country. She's a darling, really. I simply worship her. I'm afraid Daddy's side comes out a bit in me. Oh, you'd love Daddy. He doesn't give a damn about anyone. He's the one who said I could go to London and study acting. Well, you see, Chris, I couldn't bear school, so I got myself expelled.
How did you do that?
I told the headmistress I was going to have a baby.
Oh, Roth, Sally, you did it.
Yes, I did. And they got the doctor and everyone to come examine me. And when they found there was nothing the matter, the headmistress said that a girl who could even think of something so disgusting couldn't possibly be let stay on. So I went to London. And that's when things started happening.
Well, what sort of things?
Oh, things. I had the most voluptuous little room with no chairs. That's how I used to seduce men. And then one of them told me he thought I would do better in Berlin. Well, what do you think, Chris?
I think you're doing just fine. I think you're quite wonderful, Sally.
Well, I think you're wonderful too, Chris. I think we're going to be very good friends.
I think we are good friends.
You were right what you said earlier about my wanting to shock people. I do. And I don't quite know why, but I do think it was clever of you to notice it. And there's something else, Chris. Well, I'm not sure if you're going to understand this, but I did tell Fritz that my mother was French. I suppose I wanted to impress him.
What's so impressive about a French mother?
Oh, well, I suppose it's a little bit like tarts giving themselves French names to excite men. I'm a bit mad like that sometimes, Chris. So you must be patient with me.
Very well, Sally, I will. Was that all true, everything you said about your family?
Oh, of course it was. Well, most of it. You mustn't ever ask me questions, Chris. If I want to tell you something, I will, but I've got to be free.
Very well, Sally.
I've got to have a free soul. Oh, Chris, I think I'm really a rather strange and extraordinary person.
Oh, so do I. Quite extraordinary.
Oh, you are awful. Well, I'm going to go get my things in, and I'll be back in an hour, and you can help me unpack. So long, Chris.
So long, Sally. Well, I better start packing then. Well, I tell you, I'm very pleased. Sally is just the kind of person that she likes. Well, how do I know that? How do I know what kind of person Sally is? I guess that's what's quite so amazing about her is that people who talk about themselves like that ought to be lying, but I don't think she is. Yet, she's that curious little thing that my family calls a lady. Look at her. She's flirting with a taxi driver. Like she knows I'm watching her. Well, I'll write that down. Oh, okay. Okay, let's take notes. So, how would you describe Sally? So, Sally Bowles was a girl of about, I wonder how old she was. Her face was very young, but her hands looked terribly old. And they were dirty too. Dirty like a little girl's hands. Sally Bowles had the old hands of a dirty little girl. How are you? How's Natalia?
Chris, I cannot get anywhere with that girl. I've spent money on her. Money I don't have. I meet her parents, I read her poems. Poems by Henry Carey. And she always recognizes them. And then, she laughs at me. And it's not about the money anymore. but when she does not let me make love to her, it drives me ultimately mad. I kiss her. It's like my aunt. And Chris, she is beautiful and untouched by me or anyone.
Well, Sally said you ought to make a pounce on her.
No one could pounce on this house.
Well, that's why she said it would be so effective, you know. Throw her down, knock her over on the couch or something.
You do not mean this, Chris.
Well, your usual ways don't seem to be doing too well. How do you ordinarily handle it with women?
I need only uncurl my little finger and then purr a bit, and they come running. Perhaps I'll give it a try. She is away now. I write her every day, but I will write her no more. I will wait for her to come home, then I will pounce.
Good.
Snarl.
Good.
And what is with you, Chris? You still live in this tiny prison of a room?
Oh, yes.
And you can't get anyone in the room at the same time?
Well, yeah, well, if they're fond of me.
But, do you have a love life?
Well, yes, now and then.
And you will not talk about it. You English are so risky. Ultimately, Sally would not talk about it either if she did not have a French mother.
A what? Oh, yes.
She's
so strange,
that girl. Half her so frank, half so sentimental. This picture is called The King's Awakening. She takes it with her everywhere she goes. This is so childish.
Hello, Chris.
Hello, Sally.
We were admiring your picture.
Yes, The Kitten's Awakening. Oh, I've had that ever since I was a little girl. It's a dead kitten waking up in angel kitten heaven with other angel kittens all around it. Oh!
Meow, meow.
Okay, well, Chris makes awful fun of it, but I think it's rather sweet.
It's very sweet.
Oh, goodness, it's hot out and it's late September already.
Oh, you look very dressy today.
Oh, yes, it's this new hat Clive bought it for me. I don't like it very much, but it costs so much money. How about curry, Oyster? Would you like one, Chris?
Oh, no. I think they affect my back.
Chris?
I should like to try one.
Wonderful, I'll make them. Chris doesn't even know how yet.
Who is this Clive who is giving you hats?
Oh, he's an American. Chris and I met him at the Troika Bar. We were both sitting there, so bloody miserable, having a beer each when he sat next to us and ordered champagne for us both. Oh, we didn't separate till nearly 4 the next morning. Oh, and ever since then, we've hardly been apart, have we, Chris?
Oh, he's so rich, we darn let him out of our sight.
And he's just on vacation?
No, he lives on vacation. I've never seen a man drink so much. No, he says he's unhappy, but I don't know why. Do you know, Sally?
Oh, yes, darling. It's his 4 wives. So there are 4 of them, and none of them like him. And before that, it was his peculiar grandfathers that each brought him up 6 months each. And one was a Baptist, and the other lived in Paris. So no wonder it split him. He's a rather interesting character, sort of like Dostoevsky or something. He's sort of losing faith in everything. But I think Chris and I are putting it back in bits. Oh, that's why I don't feel so bad about letting Clyde buy us things. There are about a dozen pairs of silk stockings in here, and gallons of Chanel 5-0, and some silk shirts for you, Chris, some beautiful silk shirts.
My goodness.
Oh, the color is a bit outrageous, but it really is the best silk. Oh, where's something to stir this with? Oh, that pen will do. Oh, here, right. So tell me, how are things? How is Natalia? She's been calling on me like she were a district woman doing visiting, and I was a little fallen woman or something, but she seems to have stopped.
She is away now with her parents. She come back in a week, and then there will be a surprise for her. Chris has told me about your advice, that I should pounce on the tally, and I'm going to try it.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh,
what's the matter? You don't like your prairie oyster?
This is a bit painful. You drink these down all at once?
Yes, they're easier that way. Oh, especially when you're not feeling well. Oh, they sort of, you know, come back at you.
Are you not feeling well?
Oh, well, not really. I would like to lie down.
Would you like to let go?
Would you, Fritz? I'm terribly sorry.
No, of course. Sally, you lie down. You feel better. Now I go. Chris, you take her to dinner and cheer her up.
Yeah, I will try, Chris. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Are you really feeling ill, son?
Not so much ill as wanting to get rid of him. I mean, Fritz is a dear friend. He's a doll, really, but I thought if I had to go on being bright any longer, I'd die. I have something to tell you, Chris.
What is it?
Well, Chris, I went to the doctor yesterday. I'm going to have a baby.
Oh my God!
I was afraid of it too. I kept pretending it wasn't happening, but then yesterday I threw up, and this morning I fainted, and then that's what made me go.
Well, is it Klaus's child?
Yes.
Well, have you told him?
No, I haven't.
Well, are you going to tell
him? Well, I don't know, Chris. He hasn't written to me for weeks and weeks, and I wrote to him last week the nicest letter I could, and I still haven't heard from him. Not a word. You didn't like him, did you?
I didn't really know him. Didn't think he was good enough for you.
Well, that's sweet.
But you gotta tell him this now. I mean, he's gotta do something about it.
No, Chris, it's silly. It happens to other girls. Almost all other girls. But I'm scared. Do you think they all are too?
It is I, Berlin, Sally. The post is here.
Well, she has been keeping an eye out for it.
Well, come in.
There's a letter for you, the one you want from England.
Thank you.
Address still, just in case it should ever happen again.
Well, I suppose it happens quite often, really.
It can always happen. It's just bad luck. He is rather expensive, though. It is a certificate he has to give that your health will not let you have the risk of childbirth. And it costs money, that certificate.
How much money?
For this other young lady, it was 300 marks.
300?
I think we can make it a little cheaper if we argued. Maybe 250.
250? That's still quite a lot.
Oh, I know it is, Chris, but I've got to do it. You better call and see if he can see us.
You like that I come with you? Would you?
That would be wonderful. Let's say, Fräulein, where does he do it?
It is a nursing home. You stay there 2 or 3 days, and then you come back here and you rest. In maybe 10 days, no more, it is all forgotten. I go tell him.
It's like a treat for her.
Sally, everything will be just fine. The other girl's all right.
God, Chris, but there's something so degrading about it, as well as dangerous. God, isn't it idiotic? All the men I've had, and there have been quite a few, and this has to happen to me? It's just... Chris, there's something growing inside of me. Something that I can't have. That I mustn't have. It's like all the old rules and sayings were all just true.
Sally, 250 marks, and the home will cost a little bit too. I started working again, making money. If I could help you...
Chris, you are an angel. Now, I'll pay you back, I promise. What do you say you go with us? And we'll say you're the father. I think it would look better to have him there.
Of course I'll come with you.
What would I do without you? God, I hope it's no one for us. I don't want to see anybody. Fräulein Schneider, I'm not home. I won't see anyone. Please, Fräulein Schneider, don't let anyone know. It's Clive! Oh, come in. It's Clive.
Clive? Well, hello there. I just thought I'd come in and look you up a bit. Well, hello, Clive. Oh, hello to you son of a bitch. How you doing? Say, I've never seen your place before. I thought I'd come and take a gander at it. I brought you these.
Oh, beautiful. Thank you, Clive. Look, Chris, from that terribly expensive shop on Linden.
Well, good God. So this is where you live, huh? Just one room? Say, it's not very grand, is it? Can't you do any better than this?
Oh, well, I have in my time. This is just temporary.
And what's the matter with it? Well, it's rather unkempt. Not exactly deluxe, do you think?
Oh, I think it's rather nice.
Oh, sure, I wasn't casting any slurs. I just thought maybe something a bit more modern. That's okay, say, but your rooms are nicer.
Oh, our rooms are much nicer. They're beautiful.
Well, where are they?
Just towards the hall.
Come on, let's take a look.
Oh, no, they're rather untidy right now.
Well, that's all right with me.
I've got things lying around. Well, that I wouldn't want anybody to see.
Well, say, what are those things?
Well, personal things.
Oh, boy, that's what I like to look at. You got someone in there?
Well,
why don't you just come right out and say it, fella, huh? Don't beat around the bush. You got a girl in there, you could go on back to her, I'll understand.
She's sleeping.
Oh, that boy, I bet she needs it. Say, you got anything in the way of liquor?
Not much.
Oh, well, we have some gin, but I'm afraid we're out of whiskey.
Oh, you need some stores, I'll send you in the cellar. Now, look, what are we gonna do? I've been by myself all day long, and it's driving me nuts. You know, there's this place I heard of in the Wansea. Reaching a Palestine. I thought maybe we could drive there for dinner, the three of us.
Oh, the three of us?
Oh, if you're free. Oh, yes, I'll be free. It's a good place. I've always heard it was. But you've never been.
Well, it's far too expensive for us.
Ah, fine. Well, is it really a good place? Can we have a good time there, the real McCoy?
It's about the best place there is.
Oh, well, swell then. That's it. That's the real thing. Well, shall we go?
Oh, well, I would love to, but I can't just yet. I have...
Well, why? What have you got on?
Well, I have a number of... Sally, can I speak to you a moment? Yes.
Oh, that's all right. You can speak up. No secrets here. No secrets in front of Uncle Clive.
Have you spoken to the man, Fräulein? He says he can see you right away. Oh, God. And it's 20 minutes from here, so I think we should go right now. Wonderful. You get your hat and your coat, and I'll be ready. Yeah, Fräulein.
So, what man is this?
Oh, just a man. about an audition.
Well, I could drive you there.
Oh, no, that's all right. It's not a very big part. I think it would look rather silly if I showed up in a Duesenberg car.
Well, I bet it would make them pay you more.
Oh, well, that's incredibly generous of you, Clive, but I think we better go by bus.
Why, you take your landlady to auditions with you now?
Oh, sometimes. She gives me confidence.
Well, I suppose a person I could go to the Avalon and sit in the bar and wait for you there. You can bring his girl along if you want. Isn't that right, Score?
Actually, I've got to go out as well, and come back for just a few minutes, and why don't we just all meet back later at the Avalon?
I can send my car back here for you, 6 o'clock.
Fine.
Well then, good luck. I hope you get the job, man down.
Oh, thank you. So do I.
We'll celebrate tonight if you do, and if you don't, well, we could just tie a bun on it anyway, just to forget it all. So either way, you can't lose. See you later, Chris, you sexy bastard.
I thought we were never going to get rid of him.
Me neither. He is an extraordinary man.
You're right, Chris. Yes, he's rather extraordinary. I mean, perhaps after all this is over, I can devote myself to him. You know, I've always really wanted a rich man for a lover. Or perhaps maybe I could marry him. Oh, and then I might reform him.
Sally, do you think you could reform anybody?
Oh, don't do it again, Chris. Don't pull me down. I feel awful.
No, don't worry about it. I'm sorry. Don't worry about reforming anybody. You're sweet, Sally.
Well, thank you. Even if you don't mean it.
Of course I mean it. But we better get going for the...
Yes, you're right. Well, I should put these flowers in water. I guess I'll go put them in the bathtub. And then I'll come back for my coat and we'll be off. Oh, Chris, thank you for asking me to marry you.
These are the kinds of things we make dirty jokes about at school. Facts of life. And here you come to prove that none of it's true, or that you can dodge them. And then we'll get pounds and pounds spent on us for dinner, and we'll drink too much. And soon, as Fräulein Schneider said, we won't remember or believe a thing about it, the whole thing. Either of us. Or will we?